Friends, today we are going to study introduction to embedded systems. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to interpret different components of an embedded system. So before starting with the introduction to embedded system, you should stop this video here and you should recall what are the hardware as well as software components used in computer, as well as difference between microprocessor and microcontroller. What is system? A way of working, organizing or doing one or many tasks according to a fixed plan, program or set of rules. A system is also an arrangement in which all its units assembled and work together according to the plan or a program. So generally, a system is a well structured or well organized task and which is to be run according to a fixed plan, or there are some set of rules which are to be used. Example of system we can see as a watch. So the watch displays time and its parts are hardware required for the watch. There are three needles, battery, dial, chassis and strap. And this system will work on some rules, and those rules are all needles move clockwise only. Second rule is a thin needle rotates every seconds. A long needle rotates every minute, that is minute needle. A short needle rotates every hour. So there are three needles used in watch, that is second needle, a minute needle and hour needle. And all needles return to the original position after every 12 hours. So the watch is a system which have hardware, needle, battery, dial, chassis, etc. And there are some set of rules according to which that watch will work. Now we'll see what is embedded systems. So an embedded system is one that has a computer hardware with a software embedded in it as one of its important components. Its software embeds in ROM, that is read-only memory. It does not need a secondary memory as in a computer. So generally, embedded system is combination of hardware and software, and that software is to be embedded into the hardware, and that software is embedded in ROM memory, that is a read-only memory. And it does not require a large memory as used in computers. So generally, a software program is to be written and that is embedded into a hardware. So that is an embedded system. So in a figure or in that diagram, you can see that a small program is embedded in that hardware. Now we'll see computer hardware. So generally, the computer system will require a microprocessor. So that microprocessor is to be used for computing or to perform different tasks. A large memory, that memory will consist of primary and secondary memory as RAM, ROM and cache memory. That computer system includes input units as keyboard, mouse, scanner, etc. So these input units are to be used to give some inputs to computer. Output units like monitor, printer, etc. So whatever the inputs we have given to the computer system, so that computer system will work according to the input and it will generate some outputs. So that those outputs can be given as output to monitor or printers, etc. The computer hardware will use some networking units as Ethernet, card, drivers, etc. And it will use IO units as modem, fax cum modem units, etc. So these are some computer hardwares which are to be used in computer. Now we'll see components of embedded system. So there are different components used in embedded system. So that embedded system will have hardware, and that hardware consists of processor, timer, interrupt controller, IO devices, monitors, memories, ports, etc. Next is it has main application software, so which may perform concurrently the series of tasks or multiple tasks. And third component of embedded system is it has a real-time operating system, which is also called as a RTOS. So RTOS defines the way the system work, which supervises the application software. It sets the rule during the execution of the application program. Small-scale embedded system may not need a RTOS. So generally, these are the three components of embedded system, which includes hardware for the embedded system, main application software, and RTOS, real-time operating system. So that embedded system will use hardware and application software and operating system. So operating system will decide sets of rule according to which that hardware and application software will work. This is the figure which shows different components or hardware components used in embedded system, which will have a power system, a reset circuitry, oscillator circuitry, input devices or interfacing circuit, processor, program memory and data memory, timer, serial communication ports, interrupt controller, parallel ports, output interfacing driver circuits, and application specific circuit. So generally embedded hardware will require power supply. So if you take an example of embedded hardware as a Arduino board or Raspberry Pi, it will require power supply. So the DC power supply is to be given with the help of that power supply, and all the tasks in an embedded system are to be synchronized, and for that it requires oscillator circuitry. And for that embedded system we have to give some input, so it will have input devices. And next is processor, so the processor is to be used to perform those different tasks. And that embedded system will have two different type of memories, program memory and data memory. So whatever the programs are to be performed or tasks are to be performed, for that a program is to be written, and that is to be done in program memory. And whatever the data is to be required for that program is to be saved in data memory. Timer is to be required in embedded system to perform different tasks based on the time constraints, and it will have serial communication ports to send the data and receive the data serially. Interrupt controllers are to be used to interrupt the processor, which is to be used in embedded systems. It will have parallel ports to perform parallel communication, and it will have output interfacing or driver circuits, as well as it will have application specific circuit. So based on different application, different circuitries are to be used in embedded system. Next, we'll see classification of embedded system. So generally, embedded systems are to be classified in three different categories. First one is a small scale embedded system. Second one is a medium scale embedded system. And third one is a sophisticated embedded system. So generally, small-scale embedded system will have microcontroller, which is of 8-bit or 16-bit. So this is a small-scale embedded system, and complexity as well as chip size is small. Next one is medium scale embedded system. So in this type of embedded system, the microcontroller used is of 16 bit or 32 bit. So complexity is to be improved or increased as compared to the previous one. And last type is sophisticated embedded system. So more than 32 bit microcontroller is to be used in such type of embedded system. So complexity is very high as compared to those previous two types of embedded system. So based on the application, we have to use this type of embedded system. So either we have to use small scale, medium scale or sophisticated embedded system. That depends upon the application which we are using. In embedded system, we have to use softwares like C, C++, .NET, simulator as a MASM to simulate, and compilers like KIL. So these are the some software components which we are going to use in embedded system. So as I told you that embedded system is combination of hardware and software. So these type of components for the software we have to use. So the programming is to be done in the C language or C++ or .NET. And the program is to be simulated in MASM with the help of MASM, and compiler used is KIL. These are the hardware and software part of the embedded system. And next is applications of embedded system. So digital electronics, telecommunications, computer network, smart cards, satellite systems, military defense system equipments, research system equipment. So these are the applications. So as we have seen that now these days we are using washing machines, air conditioners, microwave ovens, satellites and all these electronics gadgets. So all these are part of the applications. So everywhere the embedded system is to be used. While preparing this video lecture, I have used these references. Thank you.